Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Comedy Adda. आप ये सोच रहे होंगे कि आप इतने up close and personal क्यों हैं? बात ये है कि मेरी जो co-host हैं सहित्या, उसको आज लड़के वाले देखने आए, तो वो आज शो करने नहीं आई।
लेकिन आपने घबराना नहीं है, चैनल चेंज नहीं करना है, सिर्फ मुझे बैठ के इधर बर्दाश्त नहीं करना है। co-host आने नहीं वाली, co-host आ चुकी है, presenting the लाहौरी कुड़ी फाइजा।
Good evening, everyone. I'm super happy to be here co-hosting this episode of amazing comedy series brought to you by Art of Shaving and ARY Digital, which showcases the best talent of Middle East.
आपने मुझे टैलेंट बुलाया, बहुत अच्छा लगा।
असल में तुम्हारी बात नहीं कर रही थी।
यार ऐसे तो मत बोलो।
अच्छा बाबा, बट कभी तुम्हारे पेरेंट्स ने तुम्हें ये नहीं कहा कि तुम किस लाइन में आ गए हो? You know those desi parents issues?
हाँ यार, I always wanted to be an actor. My father said it's pronounced as doctor. और देखो किधर फंस गया मैं confusion में। देसी पेरेंट्स के अपने मसाइल होते हैं।
है ना? मैं 9 बजे तक घर ना जाऊँ, मेरी माँ मुझे पागलों की तरह कॉल्स करती है।
मैं 9 बजे तक घर ना जाऊँ, मेरी माँ पुलिस को पागलों की तरह फोन करती है।
The most common question my father asks from me is, बेटा, future में क्या करोगी?
The most common question my father asks from me is, पागल है क्या? But अपने देसी पेरेंट्स के मसाइल से बचने के लिए हमने उनसे कितने झूठ बोले होंगे, right?
Like मामा जाने देना, वहाँ सिर्फ लड़कियाँ ही होंगी।
मुझे सिर्फ पेट्रोल के लिए पैसे चाहिए।
पापा, वो मेरे भाइयों जैसा है।
ये सिगरेट मेरी नहीं, ये तो अली की है।
टीचर ने तो पढ़ाया ही नहीं था, पता नहीं एग्जाम में कैसे आ गया।
वो लैपटॉप में वायरस आ गया था, इसीलिए विंडोज खुल गई।
पर उन्होंने भी हमसे पूरे बदले लिए।
हाँ, ये तो।
रज के झूठ बोला उन्होंने। लाइक बेटा, आज घर में बिरयानी पकी है।
रात के 3 बजे आप जाओ फ्रीजर से आइसक्रीम का डब्बा निकालो और उसमें से मूंग की दाल निकलती थी।
ये ईदी मुझे दे दो, मैं संभाल के रखूंगी।
ज्यादा चाय मत पियो, काले हो जाओगे।
तुम्हारी उम्र में मेरे 4-4 बच्चे थे।
फूफी की बेटी भी तुम्हारी बहनों जैसी ही है।
पर हम आप लोगों से झूठ नहीं बोलेंगे।
हम आपके लिए लाए हैं एक अनसेंसर्ड इन योर फेस कॉमेडियन।
प्रेजेंटिंग टू यू मिकदाद।
गिव इट अप फॉर असद एंड फैजा वन मोर टाइम लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। यस, ऑलराइट। इट इज सो गुड टू बी हियर। बिग राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर आवर स्पॉन्सर्स आर्ट ऑफ शेविंग। Yes, they didn't have budgets to give me one, but it's a production in Dubai, and you know how the market is, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just gonna have to go home and shave myself, just my face. But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, I've been doing comedy for about 5 years now. Yes, 5 years. Yeah, it's great, fantastic. Dubai is the best place to be funny. Because everyone can take a joke here, you know what I mean? It's great. But I've realized one thing, that doing comedy means you have to understand the audience's soul. Soul. I was going to say something else, but this is on TV. You need to understand the audience's soul. You need to know what makes them tick. Only then will your jokes work. And I'll tell you what, ever since I moved here, I had never met a Pakistani before. I did not even know what they were. I just knew that they were the people we had to get mad at when we were playing cricket. I just assumed that was the entire job of Pakistanis. You know, that's what they will do. Lose all the matches. Manager, we got paid, no? Okay. Lose all the matches. And then move on with their lives. But now I realize that Pakistanis are quite fun. But there are small differences between Indians and Pakistanis, right? I have a flatmate and he's a married man, but his wife is back home in Karachi. He's like, bhai ki bachiya dekha hai? And apparently that's the thing that a lot of Pakistanis say to you. Bhai ki bachi dekhega? Toh main bola, chal dekhte hain aur main khilona milona leke aa gaya hoon. Khelte teri bachi ke saath kitne saal ki ABCD padhti hai saale. Turns out they're talking about women. Bachis are women. And I'm like, kaise jahil,
Pachi, how can you call a girl a Pachi? And then I'm like, in English also it's babe, so what the
am I judging people for?
But I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, stand-up comedy is a great career choice. Aap kya karte ho, sir? You are into HR. You are useless. HR is the most useless profession. And I'll tell you why. Kyunki HR mein aap public ko hire karte ho, wo bhi kisi ke permission ke saath. Aap public ko fire karte ho, wo bhi kisi ke permission ke saath. और जो एक काम आप अपने खुद से कर सकते हो वो है बर्थडे केक मंगाना. तो आपको आपकी एग्जिस्टेंस पे शर्म आनी चाहिए. यू नो व्हाई आई लव स्टैंड अप कॉमेडी एचआर गाय? क्योंकि मैं यहाँ खड़े रह के सबको गधा 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 बोल सकता हूँ. तुम सब गधे का बच्चा लोगे और मेरे को ये शो के बाद पैसा मिलेगा. सबको मैं गधा बोलेगा, तू गधा, तेरा बाप गधा, तेरी अम्मी गधी, सब गधे, मेरे को पैसा मिलेगा. तू तेरे एचआर समिट में बोल सकता है क्या, तुम सब गधे हो? तू तेरे वीपी को फोन करके बोल सकता है, वीपी साहब तुम तो सबसे बड़े गधे हो, बोल सकता है क्या? नहीं बोल सकता. मैं बोल सकता हूँ कि तू किसी को गधा बोलेगा वो तेरे को गधे पे बिठा के मारेगा. आई यू नो देर आर सम वाइट पीपल दैट डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. ऑल यू नीड टू नो is three words. I said HR, I said donkeys, and I said birthday cakes. That's the gist of the story. For those of you that don't understand Hindi. And I and all of you are probably wondering at this point, KR, why are you saying gadha so much? Why are you abusing us? We paid money to watch you perform. And I'm like, yes, that's a mistake. I don't actually have to say the word gadha. Fact of the matter is, I made a bet with the ARY staff as to how many gadhas I can throw in 30 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, we are at 23 gadhas. At the end of this 21 minutes, I'm going to try and hit 50. So it is your job to count how many gadhas I throw in. And every time I say gadha, please point to the HR guy and say, yehi hai. Because that's how this night's going to go down. iPhone liya hai kisi ne? Naya wala? Gareeb audience, sorry. Miskeen. I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, iPhone buyers are in a relationship with their phones. Will you agree? They are obsessed with their phones. And even I was. Because when the iPhone first came out, no, it was like magic. It was electric. It was the first touch screen. Things are moving. It's like the first time you met your wife or girlfriend, you know? Magical. You just had to have her. Then the iPhone 2 and 3 came out. And it's like your relationship got even better. Because ab to 3G tha. Ab to stream bhi ho sakta hai maje mein. Then the iPhone 4 came out. And now your relationship, ladies and gentlemen, was at its peak. At its zenith. Lightning cable, lightning sparks, stuff was off the roof. It was mad. But then, ladies and gentlemen, your relationship with Apple and your relationship with your girlfriend started to go downhill because the iPhone 5 came out. And the problem was her father died and she didn't take it too well. Steve Chacha tapak gaye na. Things started to go downhill. Then the iPhone 7 came out. And that's when you really started to have problems. Because the woman stopped listening to you. Headphone jack nahi tha. You had to invest in counseling. And by that I mean Bluetooth headphones. And then the iPhone 10 and 11 came out, dude. Now your relationship is full gober. Just think about this. This woman has completely lost it. उसने सिर पे टैटू लगाया है एंड शी कॉल्स इट अ नॉच. हर बात में तुम्हारे से झगड़ा करेगी एंड शी डजंट इवन नीड अ रीजन, बस मुंह देखी चालू. आप अच्छे लोग सोच रहे होगे कि मेरी इतनी गंदी जबान है, बट आई टेल यू व्हाट लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट्स नॉट माय फॉल्ट. ये सब है ना मेरे बाप का फॉल्ट है. क्योंकि मेरा बाप ऐसा अजीब आदमी है कि सुबह उठाते उठाते भी सेक्सिज्म और गाली के साथ उठाता था. 5 बजे सुबह को मेरे पिछवाड़े पे लात पड़ती थी। ऐसा नहीं कि गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा स्कूल का टाइम चल ले जाओ पढ़ के आओ, कुछ भी नहीं। 5 बजे पड़ती थी साले। 5 बजे के बाद सिर्फ औरतें सोती है। और मेरे को कभी ये गुस्सा समझ में नहीं आया। आई नेवर अंडरस्टूड द हेट बिकॉज आर वंडरफुल कम्युनिटी। यस लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट्स 2019 मैन, व्हाई आर वी बीइंग जजी। आई पर्सनली लव, आई थिंक अमेजिंग पीपल, क्योंकि मेरी खुद की माँ मेरे को शाहरुख नहीं बोलती।
कभी कभी वो लोग का मूड होता है तो सलमान और ऋतिक भी बन जाता है।
एंड बीइंग कॉल्ड ऋतिक विदाउट अ सिक्स पैक, भाई मैं फैमिली पैक लेके घूम रहा हूँ, अलग ही लेवल है। पर मेरा बाप बहुत अजीब है। मैं दुबई ना भाग के आया पापा को छोड़ने पीछे, पापा तुम जाओ मैं जा रहा दुबई। And there were a lot of reasons for me to move to Dubai, right? The prospect of a new job, the thrill of moving to a new country, and the excitement of a new career. But the main reason I moved to Dubai, ladies and gentlemen, was to get the hell away from an arranged marriage. I see some white people don't know what an arranged marriage is. Don't worry, you don't have to pay.
Actually, you do. You do. Yeah, you do. You do have to pay. You do have to pay in tears. Sweat and dowry. But for those of you that still don't know what it means, an arranged marriage is a proposition in which your parents are in love with your spouse before you are.
It's a weird affair.
So arranged marriages, right? I'm talking about arranged marriages. Yes, you are having fun right now. Yes, amazing. Wow, arranged marriage, majedar, ekdam kadak. Everybody should get an arranged marriage. Insane.
Arranged marriages are off the charts. HR guy, तूने तो 100% arranged marriage ही किया होगा, क्योंकि HR वाले के साथ प्यार हो ही नहीं सकता, खलास।
You have to be an engineer to get love, bro. I'll tell you what, man. The difference is between an arranged marriage and a love marriage. All my white friends ask me, Mikta, what's the difference between an arranged marriage and a love marriage? I'm like, bro, it's exactly the same as a blind date. Exactly the same. And white people are like, really? Like a blind date? I'm like, yeah, like a blind date. But the blind date is your cousin. Who is 10 years your junior?
I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen. Arranged marriage may have made me run away from Bombay and move to Dubai. But now that I've moved to Dubai, I've realized that not everything is hunky-dory. See, Dubai also has its fair share of problems. One of the problems I face personally in Dubai is the Dubai Metro. How many of you all travel in the Dubai Metro? Give me a cheer, yes? All right! Hands up, Gareebs!
HR wale, tu to silver class mein travel karta hoga, maalum hai mere ko. Silver... What? You travel in gold class? Jhoot mat bol, tere ko to cargo mein ghusate hoge. I'm tired of picking on this guy. What do you do, brother? To matlab you are unemployed. Matlab he is unemployed. और उनके बाजू वाले सर, जो आप एकदम मनोज कुमार के माफक सिर छुपा रहे हो, आपका नाम क्या है? आसिफ है। व्हाट डू यू डू आसिफ? यू वर्क फॉर नाइट लाइफ? मतलब क्या? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय वर्क फॉर नाइट लाइफ इन दुबई? दैट्स अ वेरी डेंजरस थिंग टू से। दुबई मेट्रो इज ग्रेट है, यू गाइस ट्रैवल इन दुबई मेट्रो? यस, अमेजिंग, इट्स अमेजिंग, इट्स फैंटास्टिक।
द ओनली प्रॉब्लम इज फाइंडिंग अ सीट ऑन द दुबई मेट्रो, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। Finding a seat on the Dubai Metro is like finding a It's difficult and it's challenging. Finding a seat in the Dubai Metro is finding an HR guy who actually adds value to a company. It's difficult and it's challenging. Finding a seat on the Dubai Metro is finding a nightlife guy that actually has a clean job.
It's difficult
and it's challenging. But I've cracked the code, ladies and gentlemen. I will explain to you how to find a seat on the Dubai Metro. You need to have 3 things. Let's call them qualities. First, you need to be swift, like a gazelle, so you can get in the train before all the goddamn old ladies and children. Second, you need to be powerful. So if some of the old ladies and children manage to sneak in, you can kick them out of the way. And third, you need to be a racist. A massive racist. Now some of y'all are judging me and looking, how, what does getting a seat have to do with being a racist? I'll explain. Ladies and gentlemen, let's say you board the metro. Why did I become Bengali for a second? Let's say you board the metro at Dera, right? And the metro's full. You need a seat. Now, there's one seat and there's another seat. Both these seats are currently occupied. One seat has a very nicely dressed, posh British fellow sitting there. Right? And the next seat, there's a Taliban-looking Pathan. Okay? There are two distinct people sitting these two seats. Now the next stop is Satwa. Kaun si seat khali hogi? Aur kiske baju mein aap aada jama ke baithoge? HR wale koi idea? You are a people's person though. Which seat is getting empty? Pathan. I didn't see it, you did, huh? You are the one going to hell. Where are you from, HR guy? You are from Mumbai only. Are you? Give it up for this guy. हम लोग को देख लेगा कट जाएगी हम लोग को पाकिस्तानी टीवी शो.
मुझे पता चला कि देखो इंडिया में ARY आता नहीं है.
तो ये वीडियो किसके लिए फिल्म हो रहा है?
HR वालों के लिए.
दुबई इज फ्रीकिंग ग्रेट, राइट लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन? यस, राइट. दुबई इज अमेजिंग. What a country to live in, man. Any locals in the audience tonight? Yes? Woo! Give it up for the local guy. Give it up for him because we all want our... Local guy, what's your name, brother? Ahmed. Very obvious. Ahmed. But I like it. Thank you for coming, Ahmed. It's such a beautiful place to be. And I didn't know a lot about local culture. I only learned a lot of it when I moved here. And I've realized that locals are just super friendly, super warm, super hospitable people. And I don't have a joke about them because they're just so nice. I love local people. Local people are amazing. I love Arabs, guys. I love Arabs. Because local people like you, Ahmed, you set the benchmark in this country. You do. Because the other day I was outside Dubai Mall, right? And I saw this local guy. Range Rover, beautiful car, pristine white. And he steps out. He's wearing a kandura. And you know the local guys, how they wear their kandura? Crisp, ironed. Not one, like, crease. Not one piece of, like, what is that thing called? The lint, nothing, just pure. They look like ghosts, bro. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. And it's so majestic. I saw the local guy get out of his Range Rover and he walked into a Rolex showroom. And this is how you know these guys set benchmarks. Because he walked into the Rolex showroom, he looked at the Rolex, he bought the Rolex, and he left. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end of the story. The man bought a 140,000 dirham watch on an impulse purchase, ladies and gentlemen. That is a benchmark. I put more thought into buying a packet of Ruffle Lays before that. I ask myself a question, Migdal, do you really need this paprika goodness in your life at this point of time? Or can you hold on to next month? But Arabs really do set benchmarks here, man. Arabs do. And most people think that locals like Ahmed are lucky that they are born here, but they're not. They also have to work just as hard as our expats. And they have something that none of us have. And you know what that is, ladies and gentlemen? It's the voice. It's conviction. Let me take you to the Dubai Metro to illustrate. You see, there are two types of announcements in the Dubai Metro. The first announcement is the white girl saying, doors closing. When Cassandra from Greece is saying that, nobody cares. Because Filipinos are doing karaoke outside the train. Malayalis are taking stuff and jumping in and out. Nobody cares. But then the local voice hits the microphone, ladies and gentlemen. And when that voice hits the microphone, nobody's messing around. You're either in the train, outside the train, or pooping your pants at home. That's exactly why I got myself a local gym instructor, ladies and gentlemen. Because you can't negotiate with Arabs. The conviction in their voice makes negotiation impossible. I'm at the gym with Abdullah and Abdullah sets the treadmill on 13 on the first day. I'm like, Abdullah, I haven't seen my feet
since the Gandhi administration.
Abdullah, how do you expect me to run so quickly?
He's like, wallahi, you want your or no?
And I ran. Fantastic. But you know what? Indians and Pakistanis in the audience, make some noise. Will you agree that we as a people are the most racist people in the world?
Look at the pride. Madam is like, ha! Humko racism ka Nobel Prize milna chahiye. Kaafi der ho chuki hai. Nobody has recognized our talent.
But us Desis, we are very racist. And that is a fact. Desi people are super racist. And we are not racist to other people. Like Germans or Europeans. Nahi nahi, wo log sab mast hai. Kalle log dangerous hai, but sab baki gore, chini mene, sab mast hai. We are racist to our own people. Not just outsiders. For example, everybody from Karachi and Bombay is a Dedshana. Now, none of these things are true, okay? None of these things are true. I am here to talk about the things that bring us together. The things that make us quintessentially Desi. Things like, kuch khalo na beta. The national anthem of mothers everywhere. Or things like our career choices, you know? Growing up as Desis, we had three career choices. What were they? Doctor, engineer, third one?
Gadhe ka bachcha, there's no third option. Pagal ho gaya kya? Third option.
IT support.
Thanks, Roy.
But I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, contrary to popular opinion, I have had girlfriends. I know some of you are liking, tu?
Haan, main. Dekha hai chikne ko art of shaving.
भाई वो क्रीम घसता हो ना मुंह पे बच्चिया आ जाती है और मधुमक्खियां भी. But me and my girlfriend used to have a lot of fights. At one point my girlfriend walks up to me and she says, Mita, do you know what today is? I was like, Wednesday. And Wednesday is always the wrong answer, ladies and gentlemen. She's like, no, it's not Wednesday. It's our half a year anniversary. I was like, bandi pagla gayi hai. Half a year anniversary kya hota hai? She's like, you don't remember anything. You forgot our kiss anniversary. You forgot our week anniversary, you forgot our hour anniversary, our day anniversary, our week anniversary, our month anniversary, and now you forgot our half a year anniversary also. I was like, Bondi definitely pagla gayi hai. HR mein kaam karti hai na.
But she got really pissed off at me. She said,
never remember anything. You never share anything about your life. You don't even tell me any stories about yourself. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna address all these problems on Wednesday. So I told her, ladies and gentlemen, a story about my Uncle Juza. My Uncle Juza was my favorite uncle in the whole world. My uncle was perfect. He was a young uncle, you know, ladies and gentlemen. He'd come to my house, he'd play cricket with me, he'd teach me how to do an off spin, he'd teach me how to play video games, he'd drop me and pick me up from school every single day. This man dropped me to the airport when I was flying to the United States to study. And at the airport, ladies and gentlemen, I realized that I wasn't wearing a watch. I wasn't wearing a watch. So my uncle took off his watch and gave it to me. And he said, son, time is very important. Because time can fly, and time can change you, and time can do amazing things. So I wore that watch and I went off to the States, and then my uncle had a bike accident and he passed away. And I never got to see my uncle while I was in the States. So when I moved back, I realized that I forgot that watch on the kitchen counter that he gave me. And that is the biggest regret that I have in my life. Because that was my last memory of him. And when I said this story, my then girlfriend was in tears. She's like, thank you for sharing. And I was like, if I forgot that watch, there is no goddamn way I'm going to remember your half a year anniversary.
But you know what the difference between Pakistanis and Indians truly is, ladies and gentlemen? Pakistanis are safe from one very big societal evil that Indians have. Now, I know some of you might be thinking, ha, Sati, ha, Modi, no, none of that. India has a very big problem. That problem is vegetarians. Because at some point, you will meet a vegetarian and they will become your friend. And then you have to compromise. Kyun? Vegan cafe kaun jata hai? Bakriya nahi jati, bhai. Paneer kha kha ke. Paneer bhi nahi khate saale vegan log. But my friend Rohan is a Jain. And you know what Jain is, bro? Jain is next level vegetarian. Matlab agar vegetarian is master's degree na, Jain is PhD. Mera dost Rohan Dubai aata hai, mereko bolta hai, Migda, tu mereko Ravi's leke ja. I'm like, bro, tu Jain hai. Tu Ravi's ja ke karega kya? Because he insisted. And at the restaurant, he looks at the waiter with the confidence of a black man. And he looks at him. And Junaid Mia is standing there in his salwar kameez taking the order. And Rohan is looking at him with that RSS confidence. Veg mein kya milega? And ladies and gentlemen, this is Ravi's. This is Ravi's. Our waiter is Junaid Mia. Junaid Mia looks at Rohan and says, veg mein pakola milega. Piega Gade. How many gadas have we had now?
You guys have been a fantastic audience. My name is Migda. Thank you very much. Do I leave? Is somebody collecting me? Where's Faiza gone? Bye.